ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। आई होप माई स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू यू एज वेल एज माई वॉइस इज ऑडिबल टू यू। इफ एनी प्रॉब्लम इज देयर लेट मी नो।
सर
यस
सर, योर वॉइस इज अ बिट लो, कैन यू इंक्रीज योर?
नाउ नाउ इज देयर एनी प्रॉब्लम?
नो सर, इट इज ओके।
नाउ नाउ इट्स ओके?
यस सर।
ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट आवर today's discussion on important three points, that is history of entrepreneurship in India, second point corporate entrepreneurship, that is intrapreneurship, and social entrepreneur. So these three things we have to discuss today. Before that, we'll see how many things we have seen in last lecture. We have started our unit number one last lecture. We had discussion on content, how much content we have to discuss in this particular unit. Then we have seen assignment questions, which are important for your ISC. Then we have seen the title of chapter, that is introduction to entrepreneurship. We have seen what is the meaning of entrepreneur, what is the meaning of businessman, what is the particular difference between two, right? And we have seen the actual meaning of entrepreneur, so which was derived from French verb, that is entrepreneur. That discussion we have seen, and words history also we have seen last lecture. Then we have seen central idea of this particular unit. Then we have seen why this particular unit is important for you. That also we had discussed. Then we have seen specific outcomes of this particular unit. And then we started discussion on first bit, that is concept of entrepreneur. So with the help of these 9 pointers, we had discussion on concept of entrepreneur. And we have discussed various definitions of various philosopher, right? So around 11 definitions we have seen regarding entrepreneur, and then concept of entrepreneurship we have various definitions also of various philosopher. I think this much discussion we have made, and one more small bit that we have discussed, that is significance of growth of entrepreneurial activity. Why entrepreneurial activity is important. So with the help of these 9-10 pointers, we had a discussion on it, right? And I think we were at this point, C point, that is evolution of entrepreneurship or history of entrepreneurship. So history, what was the background of this particular entrepreneurship, especially in India? Okay, so we are not worrying about other rest world. So we are discussing about the history of entrepreneurship in India, that we have to discuss. Second bit we have to discuss, that is a corporate entrepreneurship, that is intrapreneurship, and then third bit, social entrepreneurship. So these three things we will discuss today in this particular session. While discussion of this particular history, I want to divide this particular point into two part. I want to tell history of entrepreneurship, but in two parts. First part is a entrepreneurship before independence and after independence, or during pre-independence or after independence. Swatantra purva, swatantra cha nantar. So in that two section, I want to explain this particular history. So history is little interesting. So you may be knowing like Harappan and Mohenjo-daro, this handicrafts in history, maybe in 10th or 7th or 10th, around that particular subject you have seen that particular history around before Christ 2500 in the excavation of Harappan and Mohenjo-daro, there are so many handicrafts people found, so many handicrafts, hatani banavlelya vastu bharpur tya utkhanana madhe aplyala dislya. So that history you know. What was the conclusion from that particular history? इतिहासामध्ये सापडलं आपल्याला, उत्खननामध्ये ते सापडलं. इट्स टू लॉंग, राईट? बिफोर क्राइस्ट 2500, सो इट्स टू अगो. व्हॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस पर्टिक्युलर सेंटेन्स? वी फाउंड द हँडीक्राफ्ट. व्हॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ हँडीक्राफ्ट? आपण म्हणतो हातावर, हाताने बनवलेल्या वस्तू. ओके, कौशल्य, हाताचे कौशल्य वापरून बनवलेल्या वस्तू वगैरे असं म्हणतो आपण. That time machines were not there, obviously electricity was not there. People prepared metal components, metal statues, metal pots, that things they found in that particular excavation. Its meaning is that people were having skills, they were innovative. they were having interest in preparing the various components. Means what? Entrepreneurship was there at that time. That is the conclusion. Means entrepreneurship is not a new concept. It's too old. Our ancient people already worked on it. And you know, like people were used to exchange the things. If somebody is having a good component, money was not there. How they exchange? They exchange with whatever they need. Suppose you prepared one pot, somebody will prepare another pot, you have to exchange. Like that, exchange was there. So this is one of the important sentences. Then why we are struggling nowadays to make the entrepreneur? Already entrepreneurs were there in India. And now we are struggling like people should become an entrepreneur. We are giving training to entrepreneur. Then what is the problem? Why this particular thing started vanishing? Actually, friends, a royal patronage was the one of the concept. Kings were used to give to various people. Craftsmen were there. Craftsmen means कारागीर वगैरे म्हणतो, हाताने बनवणाऱ्या वस्तू करणारे कारागीर, त्यांना क्राफ्ट्समन म्हणतो आपण. अँड रॉयल पॅट्रोनेज मीन्स व्हॉट? राजाश्रय. विच काइंड ऑफ राजाश्रय? रॉयल पॅट्रोनेज, मे बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ मनी, इन टर्म्स ऑफ सम सपोर्ट, व्हेरियस फॅसिलिटीज. सो यू मे हर्ड इन व्हेरियस स्टोरीज लाईक किंग्स वेअर हेल्पिंग दी व्हेरियस क्राफ्ट्समन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रॉयल पॅट्रोनेज. अँड दॅट्स वाय दॅट टाइम एंटरप्रेनरशिप वॉज देअर. That's why people were used to develop certain products with the help of their skills. Royal patronage was there. But maybe around 18th century, these prestigious handicrafts, Indian handicrafts, start decline. What is the reason? These are the reasons. Let us discuss. First thing, actually around 18th century, right, British people started coming here. And what they started? They started promoting their products. And our kings also stopped giving this kind of royal patronage to various craftsmen. And if that royal patronage is not there, that's why there is a disappearance of these various skills. Disappearance of royal patronage, disappearance of these various handicrafts. आपण बघतो का आता, दिसतात का कुठं हाताने बनवणारी? एव्हरीबडी इज युझिंग मशिनरी अँड ऑल दिस. कुठंतरी पितळाच्या मूर्ती बनवणारी थोडेफार लोक आपल्याला दिसतात, व्हेरी फ्यू दोज वर कॅरीड दॅट पर्टिक्युलर स्किल. ऑल्सो ब्रिटिश पीपल स्टार्टेड निग्लेक्टिंग टू आवर इंडियन गुड्स. दे स्टार्टेड निग्लेक्टिंग. व्हॉट दे टेल टोल्ड टू आवर पीपल? युअर प्रॉडक्ट इज नॉट ऑफ गुड क्वालिटी. आपल्याकडे पितळाची भांडी होती, तांब्याची भांडी होती, नंतर अल्युमिनियमची जर्मन ते अशी भांडी आली पांढऱ्या कलरची. कुणी आणली ती? ब्रिटिश पीपल. अँड डेफिनेटली दीज आर नॉट ऑफ गुड क्वालिटी. दिस कॉपर अँड आवर दिस ब्रॉस दिस पॉट्स वेर गुड, बट दे स्टार्टेड निग्लेक्टिंग अवर प्रॉडक्ट. अँड इट इज ट्रू. अँड इंडियन पीपल ऍक्सेप्टेड देअर प्रॉडक्ट्स. ऑल्सो they started giving asking heavy duty on Indian crafts. Heavy duty, if you want to export somewhere, then they started giving asking for heavy tax. Heavy duty means heavy tax, too much tax. And you know, if there is a too much tax, then cost of product will get increased and nobody will purchase it. So actually British people definitely handicapped our system, this particular economic system, whatever this ancient system was there. British people handicapped it and they started promoting their product, and they brought their low priced product at the beginning, right? And that's why this particular entrepreneurship starts declined. This is the one thing. So we should not blame, right? This happens. So some certain things we have to accept. Aplyakade hota पण ते नाही आता. सो देर इज सर्टन दॅट वन रिझन आय हॅव टोल्ड. देर मे बी द सो मेनी रिझन्स. सो ट्राय टू अंडरस्टँड, बिफोर इंडिपेंडन्स आवर मीन्स गुड एंटरप्रेनरशिप वॉज देअर, बट ब्रिटिश पीपल हँडिकॅप्ड इट. आपल्याकडे चहा वगैरे नव्हता, नाही का? ब्रिटिशांनी आणला. सो लाईक दॅट So taste and all these, and people started accepting. And in India, most of the people are common, right? We are a developing country from last few years, many years. So I want to tell one thing, like there is some problem. I have told you one reason. There may be the multiple reasons. That's why this particular entrepreneurship starts decline. This was the before independence. Now after independence, that second part I want to tell. After independence, around 1948, Indian government come forward with first industrial policy. Earlier there were no any kind of policy. And they took 1 year to make such policies, even though after independence. After 1940, around 1948, they prepared first industrial policy. What kind of policy? Maybe taxation benefits, promoting small scale entrepreneur like that. So government gave more emphasis on small scale industries by providing various incentives and concessions. What was the first thing in that policy? 1948 policy. They started giving emphasis on small scale industry, means small entrepreneur. जे कलाकुसरीची कामं करत होते त्यांच्यावर त्यांनी पहिल्या पॉलिसीमध्ये एम्फसिस केला, भर दिला. अँड दे स्टार्टेड गिविंग देम सम इन्सेंटिव्ह, सम कन्सेशन. विच काइंड ऑफ इन्सेंटिव्ह? मे बी टॅक्सेशन बेनिफिट्स अँड ऑल दिस, सम कन्सेशन इन दॅट टॅक्स, मे बी लँड अलॉटमेंट, लाईक दॅट फॅसिलिटीज दे स्टार्टेड प्रिपेरिंग. ऑल्सो गव्हर्नमेंट हॅज प्रिपेर्ड मेनी सपोर्टिंग एजन्सीज फॉर स्मॉल स्केल इन इट. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, यू नो अ व्हेरी वेल नोन ऑर्गनायझेशन टू सपोर्ट फार्म रिलेटेड एंटरप्रेनर, नाबार्ड, राईट? आपल्याला तेवढी माहिती आहे. बट देर आर मोर दॅन दॅट. इन फोर्थ युनिट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस व्हेरियस सपोर्टिंग एजन्सीज, बट लेट मी टेल वन नेम ओनली, नाबार्ड. ओके, वेल, स्पेशली फॉर फार्म रिलेटेड बिझनेस दिस पर्टिक्युलर ऑर्गनायझेशन इज हेल्पिंग, मे बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ मनी अँड सपोर्ट, व्हेरियस सपोर्ट्स. सो गव्हर्नमेंट स्टार्टेड इस्टॅब्लिशिंग सच अ व्हेरियस एजन्सीज आफ्टर इंडिपेंडन्स and started supporting such a small scale units. Then in this period, many entrepreneurs grown from small scale to medium scale. How they grown? Because they got the concession. Just a minute. Okay, so I was talking about how people grown from small to medium because government started giving various supports in the terms of incentives, concessions, and with the help of various supporting agencies, they started supporting various entrepreneurs. And during that period, small scale entrepreneur become medium scale entrepreneur and medium scale entrepreneur become large scale entrepreneur. Okay, so this was the growth, means we are moving towards the development. Okay, and with these inventions, with the inventions of computer and IT around 1970, right? So software industries also grown rapidly in India along with manufacturing industry and more than manufacturing industry. So IT era is also grown and they're also kind of entrepreneur. So this small story I have told means before, I want to divide before independence, how we were there, and after independence, now what is the situation. So this is a small story. You will say, I will say, like, this is a small story of history of entrepreneurship. Asa purvi pasun atapareinda apan aalele. And still government is preparing various policies. In fourth unit we are going to discuss, still there are various policies. After 1948, maybe around 1956, then 1972, like that, government started making revision in various policies. And now, make in Maharashtra, make in India, recent policies we know. Like that, various policies are there, and government is giving more emphasis on small scale industry, and they are trying to support various small scale entrepreneurs. Obviously, they are also supporting various large scale entrepreneurs also, but not necessary. Do you think like large scale industries need some support of government? But we see in various newspaper like so and so large scale entrepreneur got concession of 1 crore, 2 crore, and our small scale entrepreneurs are struggling to pay the loan of monthly installment of loan like that. So this is the problem. But we have to grab the opportunities and we have to take certain policies which government has. Okay. So this is about a small story, history of this entrepreneurship. Anybody want to add anything in this particular history? Because it is a very vast issue that way, history means, right? But I tried to summarize because it is a 7 mark question in examination. So we have to divide this particular beat into 2 parts, before independence, after independence. Okay, and you have to try to elaborate some pointers. Anybody want to add something in this particular history? Think for 1 minute and you can add some points maybe in chat box also, or you can unmute also and you can tell me. Or any doubt, anything you want to add? If there is no any point, then let us proceed for next bit. In IAC, such equations are important. While write up, you have to take care whatever pointers I have told. So notes of this particular points, handwritten notes are available. At the end of this chapter, I will share with you. Already, it is there in this study material sheet. Okay. Should we proceed? At least yes, say yes, no, something. Okay. Okay. Thank you. Vishali, okay, let us proceed. Now, next bit, very important bit as far as most of the students are concerned. That you will say, why, as per student is concerned, everything is for student only, right? But especially those who want to become entrepreneur, but those who are not having money, for them, you can consider this as one of the options. Corporate entrepreneurship or corporate entrepreneur or intrapreneurship or intrapreneur. Okay, so what is the meaning of this particular concept? Friend, this particular corporate entrepreneurship, its definition is like that process that goes inside an existing firm that may lead to development of new product, service, or processes. Now, which process is going inside the firm? Development of various product with the help of innovative skills. That process. New product, maybe service or process. आहे त्या कंपनीमध्ये चालू आहे. Now let me still simplify this. Actually, in corporate, many employees create something innovative within the context of their job. What is the meaning of this sentence? म्हणजे तुम्ही जॉब करत आहात, यू आर वर्किंग विथ एनी ऑफ द ऑर्गनायझेशन अँड वॉट यू डू देअर, यू क्रिएट समथिंग ऑब्विसली इनोवेटिव. यू क्रिएट सम प्रोडक्ट, यू क्रिएट सम प्रोसेसेस, सर्विसेस अँड यू सर्व टू कस्टमर, राईट? So that innovative thing you are doing as the part of job. Every employee is doing that kind of job in every organization. Now, most of the people don't have money. That's why what they do, they join nice organization and start using their innovative skill. XYZ student will say, sir, I have very nice skills. I have very nice ideas, but I need 2-3 crore rupees investment. What to do? So corporate entrepreneurship is good option for you. What you have to do? You have to join existing firm and you have to create something new there. And it may be as a part of your job. Okay. So you should not be behave like something extraordinary there. You have to be work in maybe in R&D department, maybe in production department, any department, design department. And what you have to do? You have to create something innovative as a part of job. Mukti Manal has a fayda kai. It will be noted by the organization. So and so person is very innovative. So and so person is having so many skills. and he can develop the various products. He can develop various services. He can develop various processes. And due to him, we will get crores of rupees. And apna ek to somebody is getting 10 lakh rupees, 10 crore package, 4 crores package, right? 40 crore package, 40 lakh package, right? So this terms we are listening. Why this is so? Because that particular owner knows this person is innovative. He can do something innovative and we will get something new. These people are treating you like as an entrepreneur. Even though you are recruited as an employee, they treat you like you are the entrepreneur. Getting? So, as a fayda kay ajun? For commercial success, you should not take participation. Commercial success means if you want to sell this particular product in the market, then you should not be a part of marketing person. Your individual participation is not required. Why this is so? Because they already have marketing muscles. They have marketing mechanism. They will take care of it. What is your role here? You have to develop something new. You have to create something new. Right? So for commercial success, you should not take participation. And in most of the corporate, every employee is given a chance for this innovation. You should not say like, sir, janachakade innovative skill ahe, tyanni jayche ka tithe. No, everybody will be given the chance. Every organization gives chance to do something new. Promotion kashe hotat? In on that basis only. If you are contributing to organization in terms of innovations and some benefits to that particular organization, definitely you will get be promoted. Getting? So for such an entrepreneur, so what is the word actual word? Intrapreneur, because he is inside existing firm, that's why they have given the name intrapreneur. So for intrapreneur, there is no assumption of risk, no assumption of profit, or any assumption of loss. Entrepreneur should not worry about it. When swatatri organization asel tar, you should be responsible for that, whatever profit, whatever loss, whatever risk is there, you will be responsible. But here, as a well-known organization, you have to behave like employee only, but they will treat you like a intrapreneur. And what is your most important point for you? Safe point, there is no any risk. Failure to failure. Let it be loss and let it be profit. म्हणजे हा फायदा आहे. मग एखाद्या तुमच्यापैकी कोणाकडे जर असं स्किल असेल, इफ यू आर हॅविंग सच अ स्किल विथ यू, देन डेफिनेटली यू शुड जॉईन वेल नोन ऑर्गनायझेशन फेअर दिस थिंग विल बी कन्सिडर्ड. अँड यू विल गेट फ्रीडम टू डू रिसर्च, यू विल गेट फ्रीडम टू डू समथिंग इनोव्हेटिव्ह, बिकॉज देर इज नो एनी रिस्क, देर इज नो प्रॉफिट लॉस काइंड ऑफ थिंग. यू हॅव टू बिहेव लाईक अ employee of that particular organization. Ha khup mahatvacha point hai. And if there is a freedom and all this, so in free mind you can give your full dedication to your this research. Just a minute. Okay, just a minute, there was one call. So can you hear me now? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. I was talking about the entrepreneur. Now there is no risk, so you will be free-minded person and you will give full dedication, because organization is treating you like a entrepreneur. And they will give all required facilities. For R&D, you need this machinery, you need this much manpower, you need this much money. They will start giving everything to you, right? So due to such a enormous resources of R&D and marketing muscle, larger firm lead and create remarkable new products. Because they have everything. They have research laboratories, they have research facilities, they have research fellows, and they create something new. So most of the, like, take the example of Google. Google have thousands of products. They develop thousands of products every year. Why this is so? Because they have such a facility, and they do marketing also within very less time. How? Because they have everything. They have marketing muscles, they have marketing mechanism. As a potential entrepreneur, can you do this research, this much innovative? Can you spend 2 crore for research? Can you spend 1 crore for the marketing at the beginning? Not possible, right? For common person, student like you, for potential entrepreneur like you, it is not possible. Even though you have very nice skills, not possible. But if you become an entrepreneur, this may be the possible. Atamag, who is getting more benefited? Organization where you are getting employer or you, definitely lion's share goes to corporate only, to that organization only. Google is developing so many products. They give a package like 40 lakh, 50 lakh, 1 crore to their employees. But they get the work done from them, at least one product, they do marketing, and they earn crores of rupees from that. But who is getting more benefited here? Obviously, lion's shares goes to that corporate firm only, that organizations only. So this is, you can say, like, limitation. Most of the benefit goes to that organization, because it is not wrong also, because the organization already invested on research and development. पण असे एंटरप्रेन्युअर खूप दिवस इथे राहत नाही. वाय? बिकॉज ऑलरेडी दे हॅव मनी, दे हॅव स्किल्स, अँड दे लिव द एक्झिस्टिंग एंटरप्रेन्युअर ऑर्गनायझेशन अँड स्टार्ट देअर न्यू. कॉर्पोरेट एंटरप्रेन्युअर जास्त दिवस काम करत नाहीत. सो लेट मी टेल वन एक्झाम्पल. डू यू नो दिस टू पीपल विच यू आर ऑब्झर्विंग ऑन स्क्रीन? कॅन समबडी टेल मी व्हॉट इज द नेम ऑफ दिस टू फ्रेंड्स? Anybody's knowing? Two people enjoying tea on this picture. Who are those? They are entrepreneur. Okay. At the beginning, let me tell at least one thing. They are entrepreneur. Who are those fellow? Put in chat box. Let me see how many of you know these two fellows. Take 1 minute, think. Nobody know? Friend, at least from name, behind them, at least you guess. Forget about this Google and Facebook. I am asking about these two fellows. Put in chat box. Should I ask you to put the roll number in chat box? Put your roll numbers in chat box. At the end of lecture, I will take screenshot and then we'll stop. Lecture. Ardha tas. Okay, at the end of lecture, I will take screenshot and then maybe both numbers I will verify, and then attendance will be marked. Okay, so I think nobody is knowing regarding this. So friend, let me tell these two friends' name. These are the owners, those who established Flipkart. Name of these two fellows are Sachin Bansal and Binny Bansal. Even though surname is same, they are not a brother. Okay, somebody mentioned. I am happy. Oh, it's really good. At least one person responded. So I want, these are the two fellows, they are entrepreneur. Basically, they worked with Amazon at the beginning, for your information. They They were also invested their knowledge, skill, everything there. After working there, they left that particular organization and they started Flipkart. So most of the share somebody sell. So only one person is running that. So this is not a part of our thing. But I want to tell these two fellows are entrepreneur. And their organization, whatever the process done to establish that Flipkart, this is a entrepreneurship. Getting Google is also doing same thing. They are recruiting very high skilled people, experienced people, and getting product developed from them, and they develop product. Facebook also same thing. Facebook is also doing right. So for various application, various product in Facebook, we see various new products every time in Facebook. Who develop it? Entrepreneur, and they live and they start various organizations similar to that. Getting, so this is one of the example that I have to tell. Then what are the advantages of this particular entrepreneurship and what is the limitation? So there are so many advantages and limitations also. First advantage is there, availability of resources. Whatever research you want to do, whatever innovative product you want to do, you will be having ready resources. What kind of resources? Maybe machine, maybe material, maybe man, money, right? So all resources are available if you want to become an entrepreneur. This is the one benefit. Basic setup. Sometime for basic setup also you need to pay more. But that basic setup, once you join that organization, readily you have that particular setup ready with you. Even the brand recognition. If you are working with Google, then your product will be accepted by market. Getting your product immediately will be accepted. People demand branded things in market, those who are having money. And everybody expect, even though those who are not having money, they also expect the branded product. But if branded organization will develop the product, then your product will be accepted immediately. Just a minute. Then next advantage is that sales force. So in previous explanation we have seen like sales force means marketing muscle. It's very one of very very important part of any of the business for marketing. Marketing, if you develop product and if you are not having marketing muscle, somebody may copy also before you. But if you have marketing muscle, immediately today you have developed, tomorrow you can start marketing through your channels, whatever channels are there, maybe showrooms and all these. Getting? So these are the advantages of corporate entrepreneurship, and especially for you people, those who are having potential to develop most of the nice products. What is the limitation of this entrepreneurship? First limitation is there, communicating the idea. Barashwar also hoto khup benefit hai. ह्या आयडियापासून बॉसला सांगितलं तर तो कॉपी करेल. बॉस मे कॉपी. देन व्हॉट टू डू? पीपल हेजिटेट टू कम्युनिकेट द आयडिया. मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल आर, इवन दो दे हॅव स्किल, दे आर नॉट एबल टू कम्युनिकेट द आयडिया टू हायर ऑथॉरिटी. अँड समटाइम दे अफ्रेड ऑल्सो, इफ आय विल डिस्क्लोज माय आयडिया, इफ माय बॉस विल टेक क्रेडिट, देन देर ऑल्सो प्रॉब्लेम. So this is the one of the limitation, and most of the time job security is very less. Why? Most of the time boss extract idea from you, and due to some reason he may fire you, and as it is copy your idea, he may copy and he can proceed maybe in unethical ways. This happens in corporate. Unethical, most of the unethical people follow such a ways. So job security is one of the problem. In another way, if you fail, then you have innovative idea. Suppose you have spent 2 crore rupees to develop that particular product, and that product is not acceptable by market, not acceptable by customer, then who is having trouble? Obviously organization. And if organization is having loss due to you, then also they may fire you. So in two sense, there is a job security problem. Getting? So this is about corporate entrepreneurship. I have told in the discussion of the beginning of this particular bit that this point is important for you. Most of the people don't have money. You join the organization, develop at least one product, learn everything from there, quit the organization with ample money, and establish your own. It's nice way, and it is not unethical. After a certain time, you can leave any of the organization. Most of the people say, तुम्ही तिथून आयडिया चोरून घेऊन येता आणि परत दुसरी चालू करता. It looks like unethical. No, it is not unethical, because your skills are there. You invested your skills. You invested your time. Obviously, you got some returns on it. You have freedom to quit, right? Every person is having freedom. Right, so there is no unethical thing in that. So this is one of the option you can find available for you. If you want to start your own firm, this is one of the option available for you. This is the best option. Getting? So this is explanation for this particular bit. There is a short note asked in examination always for 4 marks. So you have to elaborate this concept. Then its advantage and then limitation. So these 3 things you have to explain for 4 marks for short note. Question will be like that. Write a short note on corporate entrepreneurship, or write a short note on intrapreneurship. You may give examples also. You can have description point wise, and then advantage and limitation. Yes, have you understood? How many people think like I can become an intrapreneur? Put in chat box like yes, no, something like that. Who is interested to become intrapreneur? Put your, you can raise your hand or something. You put yes. Nobody? Respond something. Actually, responding in chat box, it's very easy. Any problem, can you respond at least in chat box? Should we proceed? Should we proceed? Am I audible to you? Okay, I am audible. Akshay, thank you. I hope there is no any doubt. So let us proceed to last bit, that is a social entrepreneur or a social entrepreneurship. Okay, and after a discussion on it, if any doubt is there, we'll discuss, otherwise we'll stop. So let me explain this particular bit. Social entrepreneur, this is also one of the option available for you. You can become a social entrepreneur. So now what is the concept? Let us discuss first. And then if doubt is there, we'll discuss. Friend, person who pursue an innovative ideas with the potential to solve a community problem. Manje kay? Person who will solve particular community problem. Person who solve the community problem, but how? With the help of innovative ideas. Then you will say, friend, earlier entrepreneur is also, every entrepreneur is solving the problem of society. Everybody is having innovation. Then what is the difference between this other entrepreneur and this social entrepreneur? Particularly, this person is solving the problem of particular community. Particular community. For example, take any example of NGO. NGOs is the best example. Here person is not looking for the creation of employment, creation of benefit, प्रॉफिट, इकड़े तो उद्देश्य नहीं है. व्हाट इज द बेसिक मोटो ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर एंटरप्रेनर? टू सॉल्व द पर्टिकुलर कम्युनिटी प्रॉब्लम. एंड काय पाहिजे? विद हेल्प ऑफ इनोवेटिव वे. इथं प्रॉफिट कमवण्याचा उद्देश नाही आहे. हिअर दे आर नॉट लुकिंग फॉर प्रॉफिट, दे आर नॉट लुकिंग फॉर एनी ऑफ द एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन, बट दे आर इंटरेस्टेड इन द सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लेम ऑफ कम्युनिटी, ऑब्वियसली विद हेल्प ऑफ इनोवेटिव वे. गेटिंग? सो दीज इंडिव्हिज्युअल्स, दीज एंटरप्रेनर्स आर विलिंग टू टेक अ रिस्क एंड एफर्ट्स टू क्रिएट द पॉझिटिव्ह चेंजेस इन सोसायटी थ्रू देअर इनिशिएटिव्स. दे वॉन्ट टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लेम ऑफ स्पेसिफिक कम्युनिटी अँड दे वॉन्ट टू ब्रिंग द सम पॉझिटिव्ह चेंज इन पर्टिक्युलर सोसायटी. मग तुम्ही म्हणाल, हे समाजसेवक वगैरे आहेत का? सोशल वर्कर अँड सोशल एंटरप्रेनर सारखं दिसायला लागले? नो. सोशल वर्कर दे आर नॉट हॅविंग, मीन्स दे आर नॉट युझिंग एनी इनोव्हेटिव्ह थिंग. हिअर कंडिशन इज दॅट इनोव्हेटिव्ह वे दॅट पर्सन शुड फॉलो. दे शुड सॉल्व द कम्युनिटी प्रॉब्लेम and they should create the something positive change in the society. Ani ito earning the profit is not a basic motto. Profit earning is not a motto, but still they are financially savvy. Financially savvy means what? They are planning to save some money. Social worker tasa kay karat nahi, paise ghya samajakun ani thode se theva kishamade. Right? So I hope you got the clear idea of social entrepreneur and social worker. So still they are financially savvy. They collect the donations, they put in bank, right? They make investment in bank and they try to use that money for particular cause. Ekada, suppose ekada example ki apang vyakti sathi ekada kaam kartoy vyakti, anath mulansathi kontri kaam kartoy, so he need money. But creating the employment, solving the nation's problem, right? His intention is to solve the particular community problem. Particular community. Kon apangata asel, kon AIDS badhita mulancha asel, nahi ka tya mulansathi madat karat asel. Palvi sarke example ahe aplyakade. So such a people, they are called as a corporate entrepreneur. Social entrepreneur. Even you can say like microfinance institutions. Microfinance organization mahite? Banki sarkes astat baga. Microfinance, they particularly work in a this undeveloped area like rural areas and all these microfinance organizations are there. What they do? They collect money, and those who need money, they distribute money to them. They have very less interest on it. So microfinance institution is one of the example. Even educational organizations also, they are so no loss, no profit. Here, giving education is the main target, right? Tumhi jithe shikla high school la vagare, earning profit is not a motto. Giving education to student, right? From rural area and all this, whatever motto they have. So educational program is also comes under the social entrepreneurship. Also helping children orphaned by the epidemic disease. Those who are having some disease, I have told example of Palvi and all these. So NGO also comes under that. So this concept is called as a social entrepreneur. Jala samaj seva karaychi hai, particularly for particular community, they can become social entrepreneur. So this is one of the example. Sharad Sagar, do you know this person? Sharad Vivek Sagar, a person from Bihar. At the age of 16, he has established this organization, Dexterity Global. You know, very well known person at the age of 16, right? Maybe aplya vesha kiti lahana hota to baga, to 10th astana apan 10th astana kay kele tumhi baga. So person and maybe this age is in 1990 or something, 28 apas 29 30 vay zala asel. Getting? So what is his mission? His mission is to connect the children from remotest area with best opportunities. What is his basic motto? खेडेगावातल्या मुलांना गोळा करायचं. And what kind of opportunity he is giving? He is making him a speakers, public speakers, giving training to them. He is thinking like children from the rural area, especially in Asia. He is working particularly in Asia. for child, especially for he is working for child, and he is giving training opportunity. He is giving training to them. And when he started at the age of 16, and what kind of opportunities to how many people till today he has given opportunity? 1.2 million students till today, maybe at the age of 28, maybe within 12 years, he has given 1.2 million students. He has trained, he has given training to them, he has made them speaker, he has developed their personality, and he is one of the 100 young entrepreneurs in the world. जगातल्या एंटरप्रेनर पैकी हा 100व्या मध्ये येतो. ही इज अ यंग एंटरप्रेनर. नाउ ही इज वर्किंग एज अ दिस सीईओ ऑफ दिस पर्टिक्युलर डेक्सट्रिटी ग्लोबल. ही इज अ फाउंडर एंड सीईओ ऑल्सो. शरद सागर, कॅन यू बिलीव मिस, आई एम नॉट टेलिंग हियर टर्न ओवर एंड ऑल दिस बिकॉज हियर इज नो इंटेंशन टू अर्न द मनी. ऑब्विसली ही हॅज मॅन पॉवर ऑल्सो, huge manpower, he has created employment also by default, but intention is not there. That he has to collect the people and he has to train them. Now have you got the idea who is a social worker and who is a social entrepreneur? Any doubt in this particular 2 points? Because both are having same cause, okay, but there is a particular difference that I have told you. Anything anybody want to ask related to this point? Social entrepreneurship. This is also one option you have. Actually, in our society, there are so many problems. Our society is suffering from so many problems. So many communities are having their own problem. Can you take one problem and can you try to solve it? I don't think like he is dedicating his whole life for that only. Yes, actually he is also having family, he is also having basic needs, so he can take some part of money from that. It is not unethical. He can take some part of money, right? Because he has to travel, he is also having family, he has to some money for his health and all this, so he can take some money. But here intention is not to earn the money, and if intention is like that, then that person cannot be a social entrepreneur. Got the clear idea? Can somebody find put one problem of society in the chat box? I will say that person may have a chance to become a social entrepreneur. Put one problem in chat box of our society, of particular community. Don't mention the name of any of the community. In chat box, just you have to put the name, sir, so and so problem. Take 1 minute. So I will take attendance screenshot, time being. You think and put one social problem in chat box. Think one problem, and simultaneously I am requesting Atharva Kulkarni, Koli Akash and Vaibhav Jagtap, you please put your roll number next time correctly. So your name is third year, TYB, so you are in last year, right? Your division.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, anybody is interested to put social, any social problem? And it may be your idea to develop the society. Okay, so any doubt is there of particular these 3 bit I have discussed with you people? History of entrepreneurship, corporate entrepreneurship, and social entrepreneurship. Anybody want to ask anything related to these three points? If no, already I have taken the attendance. You have mentioned your roll number in chat box. If no any doubt, you people can leave. Thank you very much.